Hello everyone and welcome to Autoverse back again. So in this video we will be talking about the pros and cons of the Ford Ecosport. Now let me tell you one thing guys, that the Ford Ecosport is a very well built product, but still there are certain few things which could have been a little bit more better. So we'll talk about those things in this video. So starting off from the positives of the Ford Ecosport, so the first positive which comes to our mind is the engines on offer. So Ford is offering us with two petrol engines and one diesel engine. All the engines are supreme in terms of power delivery, torque, as well as in terms of refinement. Actually, it is very difficult to find a car which has all the engine options so good. So that is certainly something to appreciate, that all the engines on offer are very good, I would say. So the first positive of the Ford EcoSport is the engines on offer. Talking about the second positive of the Ford EcoSport is the service cost of the Ford EcoSport. The service cost of the Ford EcoSport is on the lower side. It is not very expensive to maintain or upkeep. That is one of the reasons because of which a lot of owners of the Ford EcoSport are quite happy with the product. So that again adds up to a customer delight, I feel, and that is certainly something which a customer looks out for. So that is the second positive of the car. Talking about the third positive of the car, which I feel is the handling. It is one of the sharpest handling SUVs in its segment. No other compact SUVs even comes close to it when we talk about sheer handling and performance. So if you are a driving enthusiast, if you love driving, if you enjoy driving, then definitely it is the Ford EcoSport which should be your pick. So it is one of the sharpest handling SUV, and also the body roll is quite well maintained, I would say. So talking about the fourth positive of the car is the build quality. The Ford EcoSport is built to last, is a very well built product, and also the fit finish of the Ford EcoSport is quite good, I would say. So in terms of build quality, in terms of fit finish, it is a very good product. Talking about the final positive of the car, which I personally feel is the N number of safety features on offer. So definitely that adds up to peace of mind to the customer that they are traveling in a safe car. There are a lot of safety features on offer, for example the ABS, EBD, 6 airbags, brake assist, hill hold, and a lot more other features as well. So definitely those are the five positives which I feel of the Ford EcoSport. Now coming on to the negatives of the Ford EcoSport, the first negative which I feel of the Ford EcoSport is the fact that it gets all black interiors, because of which the cabin kind of feels claustrophobic and does not really feel or give you a airy feel inside the cabin, and because of that also you feel that the space is quite less. The space is already less in the car, and because of the all black interiors, it kind of makes you feel that the space is again much more lesser. So that is the first negative, that the all black interiors kind of does not give you a airy feel inside the cabin. Talking about the second negative of the car is the lack of space. In terms of space, in terms of leg room, knee room, and shoulder room, it could have been a little bit more better. It is not the best around. So in terms of headroom, there is sufficient amount of headroom, but certainly when we talk about leg room, knee room and shoulder room, it lacks a bit. So that is the second negative of the Ford EcoSport. Talking about the third negative of the Ford EcoSport, which I feel is the horizontal boot opening. The boot opens horizontally, because of which it becomes difficult to access stuff inside the boot, especially when you have a car standing right behind the Ford EcoSport. So that is the third negative. Fourth negative of the Ford EcoSport is the absence of a diesel automatic. They should have offered us with a diesel automatic. Obviously the cost would have gone up, but certainly all other manufacturers are offering us with diesel automatics. I know that they are offering us with AMTs, but even the AMT kind of does the job for the consumer who wants peace of mind or peace of comfort, who mostly drive in crowded locations. So definitely the absence of diesel automatic is again a negative point. of the Ford EcoSport. Now talking about the final negative point of the Ford EcoSport, which I certainly feel is the ride quality. The ride quality is not that great. It is on the stiffer side, because of which you can rather hear thud inside the cabin when you take it over bad roads at high speed. For most of the part, it is comfortable in the city as well as in on the highways. But as soon as you take it over bad roads, you kind of feel most inside the cabin. So guys, those were the 5 positives and 5 negatives of the Ford EcoSport. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you have any questions regarding the same or other, you can definitely ask it to me on my Instagram handle as well as in the comment section below, and I'll be more than happy to answer most of the questions. I'll see you guys in the next one. Until then, drive safe, ride safe. Bye bye.